Hey my curlies, I hope you're having a fantastic day. It's Sunday today, so happy Sunday. I wanted to do my last recording of my infused oil series. So yeah, this will be the last of the oil infusions. I'm sure some of you are partying. And today I'll be showing you how I do my coffee bean infused oil. And I will say that this oil is actually one of my favorite oils that I've made. There's just so many things that I like about it. And I will, of course, as always, have a blog post about the benefits of using coffee infused oil for your hair. And you can again use it for your skin. So it is a 2-in-1 oil, which you know by now that I love if you can use one product for two purposes. So I will have, like I said, in the description box, a link to my blog where I'll have a little more details about the benefits, and I will quickly run through them for you on the video before I get into making the oil. I'll also provide just a little bit of info that you want to keep in mind if you're going to be using this oil. And the first thing is, if you are not a coffee lover, or if you are caffeine sensitive, or you just, you know, you don't like the smell of coffee, then this oil might not be for you, because it really does have a really strong coffee scent to it. It does help to darken gray hairs or white hairs, or even if you have bleached or blonde hair. So on the one hand, if you want to darken your hair with frequent use, and that it's massaged onto your scalp as well as onto your hair for sealing, for example, to seal in moisture, then you might want to use this oil for that. However, if on the other hand you don't want to darken your hair, then you might not want to use this oil. And I will mention again, this is not an oil that is going to give you magically black hair after you've applied it. It's just known to help darken gray hairs and white hairs with frequent use, not cause you to have jet black hair if you use it. I of course use it for both my skin and my hair, and when I use it for my hair, I like using it because it helps with stimulating growth, especially if it's massaged on your scalp, like with many of the oils that I've mentioned before. If you do scalp massages with it, it is known to help stimulate growth because the caffeine actually helps to stimulate blood flow. That in turn helps with hair growth. It is known to help reduce hair shedding, which is always a plus to have more hair on your head. And for me, it is a plus that I get the added bonus of having a little bit darker hair. I like my hair color to be a bit reddy brown, so henna, hibiscus, and coffee just seems to make sense. So those are some of the reasons why I like using the oil for my hair. And when it comes to the skin, there is of course a number of different benefits. It is known to help reduce the signs of aging, so fine lines and wrinkles, especially if you use it frequently, of course. So you can just put a couple of dabs on under your eyes. And I plan on doing this for myself because, as you can tell, I have bags under my eyes, and I'll get into that in a different video. But yes, you can use it for under your eyes. It is known to help reduce the appearance of dark under eye skin, I guess it's called, so you can use it for that as well. It can also help to fade really fine stretch marks or acne scars. Again, you need to use it frequently to see the results, and you can of course use it on your body. One thing I do want to mention is that you want to use real coffee beans when you make the oil, so don't use instant coffee. That's just, it's not gonna cut it. You want to use the proper coffee beans, and the ones that I use are roasted coffee beans. If you have organic coffee beans, you know, you can use that. And yeah, if you're using instant coffee, you're just not gonna get the same results. So stay tuned to see how I make the oil. I am obviously using coffee beans, and you can either use them whole like this, or you can do what I'm going to do, which is just to very, very lightly grind them up. But I mean, literally just a few seconds in a blender. And I'll show you what they look like once I have finished grinding them. And then I'll be using almond oil. I will be using 1 cup of almond oil. I'll be putting the coffee beans into my filter paper once I finish blending them. String to help tie up the coffee filter once the coffee beans are inside. And everything will go into my container. Alright, let's get started. I'm just going to blend this up first, and then I'll be back. So I have very lightly blended up the coffee beans, and I do this because the natural oils in the coffee beans become more exposed if you blend them up a little bit. You don't have to do this. And I'm not sure if I mentioned this, I used 1/3 of a cup of the coffee beans. I just have it in the center of the coffee filter, and then I'm gonna close it up. Make sure that it is secure. If it isn't, it's fine because you can just filter out the oil afterwards. So I squeeze my coffee filter into the container, and then I'm just gonna add my almond oil, and I'm using, like I said, 1 cup. Now this looks like a lot of oil, and it is. I'm going to be using this for both my hair and my skin for different recipes, which I will share with you. So I am making a bit of oil. So just make sure that everything is covered. And I'll leave it like this for 2 weeks in a nice and warm place with no direct sunlight. And every day I'll just be shaking up the bottle. And then after 2 weeks, I'll just separate the oil from the filter, add my essential oil, and then I'll have my coffee bean infused almond oil.